Hi, welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. I have my front door open. My neighbor is working on his house.
I don't know what he's really working on, but you may hear them.
And Bruce is up. He's walking around right now. That's the wonderful thing about Bruce is his spirit is really good, really high, despite what's happening to him.
Bruce.
No. So what I thought I'd share with you this week, flip through of my Hobonichis. In here is my A5 hun. There's Bruce, my cousin. And in here is my 5-year diary. He's looking for his ball, which I have right now. I'm sitting on it. It's this guy.
Here comes Bruce.
So let me show you my 5-year cousin size Hobonichi. It's inside the, I can't remember the name of this, vacancies. Here's the first one that I did on the 1st of March. As you can see, I haven't colored it in. And you might see the pencil marks on it. So this is a black-footed albatross.
Bruce.
This is a Brazilian flea toad. It is the world's smallest animal with a backbone. This is supposed to be a finger. It is the bumblebee bat. And it also holds the Guinness Book of World Records as the world's smallest bat. He's sitting on a finger. It's a shrew. I don't know if you can see it. Here's my blue-footed booby. And it's also really tiny. The body length is 1.6 inches, excluding the tail. This is a golden-backed frog. And once I color it in, you can tell a little bit better. But there's a small little mushroom growing on the side of the body. And the photo credit, I can't pronounce his name, goes to L-O-H-I-T space Y space T. So I thought that was pretty interesting. I thought it deserved a spot in the sketchbook. And I think this is the last one. This is a Eurasian coot with the baby. Photo credit goes back to Nikki. Is it P-E? I don't know how to say that. So that is a look of my 5-year. This is what it looks like now. Still not too chunky. Let's go into the current week. Kept it pretty simple. Washi on the bottom. Packages on the side. Since I had time this morning when I was drinking my coffee, I went ahead and filled out what my plans were for the day or the things that I needed to get done. This is for last week. And the week before. Let's now go to, you know what? I don't know if I did anything for the monthly. Okay, so I just did a little bit of decorating. I'm trying to use it this green washi, so that's why you find it here, as well as down here. I think I left off on the 28th of February. So on the 29th, I went ahead and cut off all the avocados on my tree. I have a Haas avocado tree. Last year, I waited until I think mid-May. And by then, the avocados were past its prime, so to speak. So somebody suggested that I start around the mid-February to end of February. And because it was raining so much this past month in February, I decided to cut all of them off before the next storm came in. So I got this year 2, 4, 6. I got 7 avocados. One of them, the biggest one, was about the size of my hand. And hopefully these will be good. I still have them ripening right now on the table. This is a selfie with my mom that my brother sort of included everybody's faces in. And I thought it was kind of funny. So I went ahead and put that there. This is the March blank page that I've been using as a thinking about page. So let me show you what I did for February. So here's my February page. And for January, I did that. And then the stickers are from Happy Planner that I've been trying to use up. And then like these little guys, I think I picked up either from Daiso or from the Sanrio shop in the mall. But I plan to fill this out probably mid-month. On these 2 days, I decided to put down some washi tape that I purchased from Jet Pins. I think I had mentioned a few videos back that I was going to place an order at Jet Pins for some pen refills for my Hobonichi pen. I picked up 5 washi tapes. This one is called London. These, and I like them because they look like stamps. So hopefully that's not too blurry, but you can see what those look like. With the London washi tape, these are the choices you get. This one is called Animal Musician, and these are the choices. And I plan on using these to decorate the weekly pages in here that you've seen, and I'm going to show that to you here in a second. This one is called Wonderland, so here are the 6 stamps you get. This one's called Jungle, and this one's called Safari. And the Safari one, my favorite, is the Rhino. But I really like the way the stamps look, and I like the way how this came out. On Monday, this past Monday, we took Bruce to the vet. This is the selfie pic that we had with Bruce in the car. So here's myself and my husband. Because Bruce gets really excited when he sees other dogs, and with his heart condition, it's safer for us. I'm more comfortable leaving him in the car with us until they call us, and then we come out and then we meet the tech in the parking lot, and then we go in through the back door. We were here waiting to go into the vet's office. Now on this page, I didn't have much that I wanted to remember, but I did find this neat page on our AAA travel guidebook magazine that they send us from time to time. Bruce. So this is, you can take a train to the Grand Canyon. So one of these days, I've been to the Grand Canyon once when I was a kid. My husband's never been there. Maybe one of these days, we'll try and do this because it looks like fun. And so I put the little double-sided tapes on the back of the, on the Hobonichi paper. And then once I had the tape laid down, then I laid the page on top of it. And so that's how this one looks. On Wednesday, so here's Bruce sleeping on the couch. And then this is Bruce on the bed beside me, sleeping. Here's Kit Kat. Kit Kat is our neighbor's cat. I caught him watching the birds in the front yard. He's figured out our front window. So he'll sit there at the front window. The front door is right here. And he knows to sit here and kind of tap on the window when he wants to come in. Smart cat. And then here's Friday, which I haven't done anything yet. That's my cousin. Lastly, let's end with my A5 Hobonichi Hun, as well as my traveler's notebook, which I keep track of my meals, weight, steps, and I keep it in here. I haven't filled out this morning yet, but this is my weights and my steps. Weights are colored, steps are not. This is for this week. So this one, I generally fill out the day after. Like this morning, I would have filled this out, as well as my sleep. I only did the arm weights one day. And then stickers I keep in here. And in here, this is my writer's notebook. This is my weekly layout. This is last week. This is the week before. The week before that. That is a look of what I've done this past week in my Hun, my cousin, and my Hobonichi 5-year diary. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see after the pin videos generally of my Hobonichi. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Have a great weekend. Bye.